Hey, what's up, DIYers? Mike Boards with the Mike Boards channel. Thank you for watching. We're talking freezers today. And in the event that your freezer is not freezing your food, we are going to show you a quick, friendly procedure that will hopefully reset your system and get your freezer back up and running. Let's get started.
All right, DIYers in the kitchen now, and here is our GE refrigerator. And unfortunately, the freezer just stopped freezing. And you'll notice right here, the freezer is 28 degrees and the refrigerator is 55 degrees. Now we have them set at 36 for the refrigerator and -1 for the freezer. So as you can see, there's a big issue. Let's go down to the freezer. 1, 2, 3. And in our case, our compressor is up and running. We'll go ahead and close that. And again, wait about 3 to 5 seconds. Nothing happens. Let's go to our circuit breaker panel because it is easier to trip the breaker as opposed to pull this refrigerator out and gain access to the plug. At the household circuit breaker, and here's a gift from my parents, sunshine and salt water. How cool is that? I'll set that aside. And inside here are the circuit breakers. In our case, number 2 is the refrigerator. And at this point, what you want to do is turn it off and leave it in the off position for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, go ahead and turn it back on and head back to your refrigerator. Now, in the event that you can gain access to the plug to your refrigerator and unplug it at the outlet, do that as opposed to this. However, definitely know that that is an option as well. And we'll head back to the refrigerator. Come back down below to your freezer. Do the 1, 2, 3 on the switch, and hopefully you will hear that sound. And we just did that just a few minutes ago and got it back up and running. So what we'll do is monitor the temperatures. Again, the freezer's 28. Go and make sure everything's shut. And what we'll do is come over to the time. It's 11:45 a.m. We'll wait about an hour or two and we'll show you the temperature change. And while we wait, couple things can cause this. The most common cause is a power outage. We have all witnessed and experienced a power outage. And the most common reason this can happen is a quick power outage or a temporary power outage, meaning the power goes out for about 3 to 5 seconds and then comes back on. And unfortunately, that can actually cause your refrigerator to go into stationary or protection mode to protect the internal parts and control board. All right, DIYers, it has been exactly 1 hour and 15 minutes. Let's go ahead and check out the temperatures. And we are at 23 and it was 28. We are making progress and moving in the right direction. Hopefully this helps. DIYers, hey, do us a favor, below the video, you'll see that thumbs up icon. Click on that, like the video, subscribe to the channel. Definitely ring your YouTube bell. That would be very helpful to us. We would really appreciate it. Thanks again for watching. And one more thing, in the event that you hear a loud screaming or squealing sound coming from your refrigerator, definitely check out the link scrolling above. It is going to show you exactly what is going on and causing that. It's now 3:20 in the afternoon, and we're down to 10, and it's taken a while because it's empty, and that's normal. We haven't gone shopping yet. We just moved back in, and freezers are most efficient when they are packed full. Refrigerators are most efficient when there is space in between the food items. Just wanted to give you a quick update.